Hey, I'm Dale, and today I just wanted to do a quick little video on how to make the ORTON effect butt sharp. So, a little bit of background behind this. You know, when I first learned how to do the ORTON effect, the one thing that it didn't quite have was a little sharpness that a lot of people kind of seem to have with their images, whether that be selective in areas or just overall. It still had the dreamy feeling, but managed to also have the sharpness in the edges. So let's jump into an image that I've been working on at the moment, and I'll show you what I can do. So we're in Photoshop here. I'm towards the end of editing an image. Generally, when I do an ORTON effect, I do it either at the start, just to kind of give a feel and help kind of change the direction that I want to edit the image, or I do it at the end, just to give it a little bit of pop. So there's a couple of ways you can do it. You can either go into TK Actions. So TK Actions is a luminosity mask panel. You can get it for free, and you can do a selection. So I'll do a selection on the lights. Generally, that's what looks good for ORTONs. So we'll do a lights one selection. That'll grab absolutely everything, and then down bottom left here, do a ORTON effect. What this will do, and this is how I used to do it, is create an ORTON effect specific to those luminosity values. So in this case, it's the lights one, which will be pretty much the most highlighted bits of the image. Gaussian blur, let's change that to 15. Actually, no, let's go to 25. So then I can show you the comparison between this and then the other technique that I use for the ORTON effect. Okay, here we go. So it's doing the adjustment now. Okay, and we can see it's put it in a folder just here. So without and with. So you can see it's quite aggressive in this case, and it's only specific to the highlights. However, I do like having the feeling over an entire image. So let's do the other effect. So first things first, just so we can start from scratch, create a stamped layer. So on the Mac, it's Command-Option-Shift-E or Control-Option-Shift-E on a PC. That'll stamp the layer, so that'll get everything everything together. It'll flatten it all. And then we go, so we select that top layer, we go Filter. It to go filter blur Gaussian blur. Now in terms of the radius, I sit at about 25. People say that it should be the radius of the size of your sensor. So I've got a Nikon D610, so the sensor size for that's about 24. So I generally go about 25, but it's photography, it's art, you can kind of do whatever you want, but I'll sit on 25 for the moment. Okay, so that's applied that Gaussian blur to that specific layer. Then if we go to Image, Adjustments, Brightness and Contrast, what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring up the contrast to 100%. So that's gonna kind of really, really dial it in. And then the brightness, that can go plus or minus depending on the feeling that you wanna have in the image. I'm gonna go 5. I'm going to go okay. Now, you can see you've just got a blurry, dark image with nothing on it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the opacity and change the opacity to 15. So let's have a little look here. So that's before, that's after. Something that's really, really nice about the ORTON GLOW is it gets rid of all those micro contrasts that you can see, and it kind of helps simplify the image. Anyway, so let's get that there. Now, it looks all right, but pretty much everything is blurry as well. You know what I mean? Just because of the nature of the ORTON GLOW, it makes everything look dreamy and nice, which is fine, but we can do a little bit better. So what we're gonna do is we're going to duplicate the original layer. So Command or Control J. And then we're going to go filter, filter other high pass. And then we're going to do a high pass of 1 pixels. So high pass is there. So it's going to apply the high pass to that image. Now you've got a super duper gray looking image, which is completely fine, but it's all the little adjustments, and you can probably just see them, little bits and pieces it's got in the edges. It's just kind of sharpened it up a little bit. So what we'll do is we'll make the other layer visible, and we'll put the high pass layer up there. We'll rename that high pass, and then the one underneath we'll rename to Auden. With the high pass, just because it's in the normal layer mode at the moment, we're going to change that to, I'm pretty sure it's overlay. Yep, to overlay here. So just from the outset, it doesn't look like it's done much, but let's zoom into this kind of focal point here, so these trees, and then let's turn off the high pass. So you can see it's kind of blurred it a little bit with just the straight up Auden, and the high pass has come through and added more details to it. Now, you might not necessarily want the high pass everywhere. You might want to, let's say you're doing an Auden effect and it's a mountain or something like that. You just want the mountain to be sharp. You want the area around for aesthetics to be still blurry and Auden looking like. What you can just do is you can create a layer mask on that. So just down here, layer mask, white reveals, black conceals. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to go X to switch the primary black and white brush swatches, and then go a command or control delete, and that's going to fill that high pass layer with black. So black conceals, white reveals, it's stuck in my head. And then what we're going to do is we can get a brush with an opacity of about 100%, so keep it at 100, and then we're just going to selectively go through and focus and just click on those trees there. So we're keeping that area there specifically sharper and the rest not sharp. So if we have a look, so I'm doing the forward slash here. If we have a look at the kind of masking that's going on at the moment, you can see here the areas that are red are the areas that haven't been masked, and the areas that are that you can see there have. So let's turn that off and then turn that on. And then let's just have a little zoom into that area again. So this is with it on and then off. So you can see this area here with all the light rays and stuff coming in it. That's still blurry and still nice and still kind of ethereal and stuff like that. However, the trees are a little bit more in focus and kind of help bring the eye to that focal point. Anyway, I hope that was interesting. I hope that was helpful. Let me know in the comments if it was. Like, subscribe, all those good things, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.